Hi friends, welcome back. Today we are going to solve LeetCode problem 922, sort array by parity 2. Before we go through the description and some examples and solution, I just want to mention that my channel is dedicated to help people who are preparing for coding interviews or Java interviews. On my channel, there are more than 200 solved coding problems which were taken from previously asked interview questions by big tech companies like Amazon, Apple, Google, Facebook, Microsoft, Yahoo, and many others. And those are selective problems to cover important varieties such as dynamic programming, graph problems, binary search tree problems, binary search related coding interview questions, as well as BFS, DFS, and matrix related coding interview questions. So if you are preparing for coding interviews or Java interviews or simply want to learn different Java concepts, please subscribe to this channel now. This channel can definitely be helpful in your job interview preparation, so please subscribe it. So let's quickly look at the description of the problem. Given an array of integer nums, half of the integers are odd and other half are even. Sort the array so that whenever nums I is odd, and whenever nums I is even. Return any answer array that satisfies this condition. So they have given us some examples over here. So the array is very big in length, right? So 2 into 10 raised to 4, you can see. So so let's just take this one example over here, and we will first understand how we are going to solve this problem, and then we can implement our solution. So this one is the input array, right? 4 to 5, 7. So we have to make sure that our even indices should have an even number basically, and odd indices should have an odd number. That is what the solution we are trying to find, right? So what we will do is we will take two pointers, one let's say x pointer, and this x is equal to 0 in the beginning, and one is y pointer, y is also equal to 0, right, in the beginning. So x pointer we wanted to use for even numbers, right, and y pointer we want to use it for odd numbers. So what we will do is we will iterate through 0 to n in this array, and whenever we find any even number, we will just put that into the even x location and we will increment x by 2, right? And when we find an odd number, we will put it in odd location and we will put like increment y by 2 basically, right? So let's just go through this example. So we are finding, let's say, when we are at 0, we find 4, right? So we will create one array called as, let's say, R is our resultant array that we want to return, right? So we will create the array of the same length as the original array. And we will first put, like, let's say, this array is there, right? So array of, so first number is even. So we will check if it is even number, then we will just put X here, right? Means 0 basically, right? X is 0. And then we will put that number here. So 0 is equal to 4, and we will increment x by 2. So now x become 2, right? And then we will go to the next number. So next number is again even number. So we will put array of even number is 0, and now it is 2, right? So we will put 2, and we will put here the even number again, right? And we will increment x by again 2 basically, right? So now x becomes 4. So now let me just change the color. So now we will we are at this location, right? So now our index I is equal to 2, right, in the original array. So now we are looking at a number which is odd number, so we will take y. So y is equal to, sorry, so y should be starting at 1, right? Y should be starting at 1 in the beginning, and then we will keep incrementing every time by 2. So y is 1, so array of 1 we will put because it is odd number, and we will put that number here 5, and then we will increment y by 2. So now y became 3, right? And then again we are at 7, so 7 is again odd number, so we will go and take y. So now y is equal to 3, right? So we will put 3 here, array of 3 which is equal to 7, right? And then we will increment this y by 2, so y becomes 5, right? Now, so now this array, we, if you look at this array that we populated in this array, all the even indices has even number. So 0 has 4, 2 has 2, right? So both even numbers, and odd indices have odd number. So 1 has 5, 3 has 7. So basically we just use two pointers x and y. X is 0 in the beginning, y is 1 in the beginning, and whenever we find any even number, we will use x and we will zero, right? In the beginning we will use x and we will increment that x by 2. If we are finding an odd number, we will use y and we will increment y by 2, right? And just we will populate our new array in that way, and we will just return our new array as our answer, right? As you can see, 4527, here also 4527. So this is the way we can solve this sort array by parity 2 problem. This is also one popular interview problems in many big companies. So make sure you understand this problem and how to solve it. This is the fastest way, I think, to solve this problem, because with the help of two pointers, and it's very clean also implementation wise. So let's just look and look at the implementation for this problem. So I just got nums.length as n, right? N length of the original array. Then we created one array that we wanted to return, right? And it is the same length as the original array that is given to us, nums. And we initialized x and y, these two pointers approach we are using, right? So x is 0, y is 1. X we will use for even numbers. This is for even numbers, and y we will use for odd numbers, right? And then we are iterating through 0 to n through the original array. Whenever we find any even number, we will use x, right, to put that number, and we will increment x by 2, right? Otherwise, if it is an odd number, we will use y and we will increment y by 2. So in this fashion we will populate our array, right? And we will just return our array as I shown you in this example, right? So this way we can guarantee that this array that we created, for even indices we will always have even numbers, and for odd indices we will always have odd numbers, right? So let's just take some examples. So this is the example that is given to us, so we can just take this example. So as you can see, we are getting correct answer 4527. So we can just create like some more let's say even and odd numbers here. So let's say we added 9 here and then we added 10 here, right? So let's just quickly run through this example. So we are getting 4, then 2, and then 10, right? So all the even indices have even numbers and odd indices has odd numbers like 5, 7, and 9, right? So our solution is working fine. So we'll just go ahead and execute against all the test cases that are given to us. And we will just submit our solution. So all are passing. So we'll just submit our solution. So as you can see, the time complexity for this solution is order of n, right? Because we are iterating through the solution. So our solution got accepted here by LeetCode, and it is 96% faster than other submissions and 60% on memory side, which is pretty good. So as you can see, so our time complexity will be order of n because we are iterating through all the numbers in the nums array. And we have used a separate array to populate the resultant array, right, that we want to result. So this is also order of n space complexity, right, because it will take n number of spaces for this new array that we are creating. Others we are using just pointers. So both time complexity and space complexity is order of n. So time complexity is order of n here, and the space complexity is again order of n for the array that we used here. If you haven't already looked into my channel's playlist, there is a separate dedicated playlist for LeetCode and LintCode solutions. So please check it now. It has over 200 different solved problems which were taken from different coding interview questions asked by many big companies like Amazon, Apple, Google, Facebook, Microsoft, Yahoo, and many other companies. And those problems are very important from coding interview perspective. They constitute graph problems, binary search tree problems, binary search related coding interview questions, linked list, string related coding interview questions, as well as BFS, DFS, and matrix related questions. So if you like this video, please hit like and subscribe this video.